Welcome to second session of lesson number 15, probability. In the first part, we have studied about the difference between experimental probability and theoretical probability and the formula to find probability of an event, that is number of favorable outcome upon total number of outcomes. Then we discussed about the complementary events. Now, today we will move to exercise 15.1, question number 17. Question number 17, in that first one, a lot of 20 bulbs contain 4 defective ones. One bulb is drawn at random from the lot. What is the probability that this bulb is defective? Question number 2, suppose the bulb is drawn. In that, question number 1 is not defective and is not replaced. Now, one bulb is drawn at random from the rest. What is the probability that this bulb is not defective? In question number 1, the total number of outcomes, that is the total number of bulbs, equal to 20. Number of favorable outcome, that is number of getting defective bulb, that is 4. Therefore, probability of getting a defective bulb equal to number of favorable outcomes upon total number of outcomes, that is 4 upon 20 equal to 1 upon 5. Question number 2, when one bulb is kept aside, the total number of outcomes is 19. Number of favorable outcomes, that is the number of good bulbs, that is 19 minus 4, that is 15. Therefore, probability of getting a good bulb equal to number of favorable outcomes upon total number of outcomes, that is 15 upon 19. Question number 18. A box contains 90 discs which are numbered from 1 to 90. If one of the discs is drawn at random from the box, find the probability that it bears number 1, a 2-digit number, number 2, a perfect square number, number 3, a number divisible by 5. So first you have to write total number of outcomes. That means you are having discs numbered from 1 to 90. That is, total number of outcome is 90. Then, number of favorable outcomes. In question number 1, you have to get a 2-digit number. So, from 1 to 90, the 2-digit numbers start from 10 to 90. That is 81 numbers. Therefore, probability of getting a 2-digit number equal to 81 upon 90 equal to 9 upon 10. Question number 2, number of favorable outcome equal to number of perfect squares. So starting from 1, you are having 9 perfect squares, that are 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49, 64, 81. Therefore, probability of getting a perfect square equal to 9 upon 90 equal to 1 upon 10. Question number 3, number of favorable outcomes, that is numbers divisible by 5. From 1 to 90, there are 18 numbers, that is 5, 10, 20, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, up to 90, you are having 18 numbers. Therefore, probability of getting a number divisible by 5 equal to 18 upon 90 equal to 1 upon 5. Question number 20. Suppose you drop a die random on the rectangular region shown in figure. What is the probability that it will land inside the circle with diameter 1 meter? Here, two geometrical patterns are given, that is, one is the rectangle and the other one is a circular region. When you are finding the probability of a die land inside the circle. Here, the total outcome means the area of the outer figure, that is area of the rectangle. Here, the length and breadth of the rectangle is given, and we are already learnt area of the rectangle is equal to length multiplied by breadth, that is 3 multiplied by 2 equal to 6 meter square. Now, the die will land inside the circle. That means our favorable outcome is the circular region. So, area of the circle equal to pi r square. Here, diameter is given 1 meter. Therefore, radius is 1 upon 2. Therefore, area of the circle equal to pi multiplied by 1 by 2 square. That is pi upon 4 meter square. Now, probability of dropping the die inside the circle equal to favorable outcome upon total number of outcomes, that is pi by 4 upon 6, that is pi upon 24. Question number 23. A game consists of tossing a 1 rupee coin 3 times and nothing its outcomes each time. Hanif wins if all the tosses give the same result, that is 3 heads or 3 tails, and loses otherwise. Calculate the probability that Hanif will lose the game. While tossing a coin 3 times, the total number of outcomes are 8. You can write the outcomes by drawing a tree diagram that you have studied in lower classes. And it is given that Hanif will lose the game if the outcomes are other than 3 heads and 3 tails. That means out of 8 outcomes, if you are removing 3 head and 3 tail, the rest are 6 outcomes. So here the favorable outcomes means 6. Therefore, probability that Hanif will lose the game equal to number of favorable outcome upon total number of outcome, that is 6 upon 8, that is equal to 3 upon 4. Question number 25. Which of the following arguments are correct and which are not correct? Give reason for your answer. In that question number 1, if 2 coins are tossed simultaneously, there are 3 possible outcomes, 2 heads, 2 tails, or 1 of each. Therefore, for each of these outcomes, the probability is 1 upon 3. That is, when you are tossing a coin 2 times, the total number of outcome is 4. That is, head head, head tail, tail head, and tail tail. Probability of getting 2 heads, that is, you are having 1 time head head. So, 1 upon total number of outcome is 4, that is 1 upon 4. Probability of getting 2 tails, that is 2 tail is having only 1 outcome with tail tail, that is 1 upon 4. Probability of getting 1 head and 1 tail. There you are having 2 outcomes, that is head tail and tail head. So favorable outcomes are 2. 2 upon total number of outcome is 4. 2 upon 4 equal to 1 upon 2. Hence, this argument is incorrect. Now, in question number 2, if a die is thrown, there are 2 possible outcomes, an odd number or an even number. Therefore, the probability of getting an odd number is 1 upon 2. Here, the total outcomes are 6 and odd numbers are 1, 3 and 5. That is, 3 is our favorable outcomes. Now, probability of getting an odd number equal to favorable outcome upon total number of outcome, that is 3 upon 6 equal to 1 upon 2. Now, probability of getting an even number out of these 6 outcomes, even numbers are 2, 4 and 6. So, our favorable outcome is 3. Therefore, probability of getting an even number equal to favorable outcome upon total number of outcome, that is equal to 3 upon 6 equal to 1 upon 2. Hence, this argument is correct. Exercise 15.2, question number 1. Two customers, Shyam and Ekta, are visiting a particular shop in the same week, Tuesday to Saturday. Each is equally likely to visit the shop on any day as on another day. What is the probability that both will visit the shop on number 1 same day, number 2 consecutive days, and number 3 different days? Here, total number of outcomes equal to 5 multiplied by 5, 25. You are finding the total number of outcomes as in the same way when you are tossing two dice. That is, here it is Shyam and Ekta visiting the shop Tuesday to Saturday. So you write the outcomes Tuesday, 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 Wednesday, Tuesday, Thursday, Tuesday, Friday, and Tuesday, Saturday. Like that you will have 25 outcomes. In question number 1, both of them will visit the shop on the same day. So, number of favorable outcomes, that is both of them are visiting the same day. You can see here Tuesday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Thursday, Friday, Friday, Saturday, Saturday. That is 5 outcomes are there. Now, probability of both will visit the shop on the same day equal to number of favorable outcome upon total number of outcomes. That is 5 upon 25 equal to 1 upon 5. Next is you have to find the probability that they will visit the shop on consecutive days. So here consecutive days are 8. That is Tuesday, Wednesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Thursday, Friday, Friday, Saturday, again Wednesday, Tuesday, Thursday, Wednesday, Friday, Thursday, and Saturday, Friday. There are 8 favorable outcomes. Therefore, probability of both will visit the shop on consecutive days equal to number of favorable outcomes upon total number of outcomes. That is 8 upon 25. Question number 3. Probability that both will visit the shop on different days. That you can find by using the formula P of E bar equal to 1 minus P of E. That is 1 minus probability of both will visit the shop on the same day. That we have already find out as 1 upon 5. Therefore, 1 minus 1 upon 5 equal to 4 upon 5. Therefore, the probability that both will visit the shop on different days equal to 4 upon 5. Question number 3. A bag contains 5 red balls and some blue balls. If the probability of drawing a blue ball is double that of a red ball, determine the number of blue balls in the bag. Since the number of blue balls is not given, you have to take let the number of blue balls equal to x. Number of red balls equal to 5, that is already given. Therefore, total number of balls equal to x plus 5. Probability of getting a red ball equal to number of favorable outcome upon total number of outcomes, that is 5 upon x plus 5. Probability of getting a blue ball equal to number of favorable outcome upon total number of outcomes. Number of blue balls is x. So you will have x upon x plus 5. Now according to the question, 2 times probability of getting a red ball equal to probability of getting a blue ball. That is 2 multiplied by 5 upon x plus 5 equal to x upon x plus 5. the common factors on the both side you can cancel it. So you will have 2 multiply by 5 equal to x. Therefore, x equal to 10. Therefore, the number of blue balls equal to 10. Question number 4. A box contains 12 balls out of which x are black. If one ball is drawn at random from the box, what is the probability that it will be a black ball? If 6 more black balls are put in the box, the probability of drawing a black ball is now double of what it was before. Find x. Total number of balls equal to 12. Total number of black balls, that is x. Therefore, probability of getting a black ball equal to number of black balls upon total number of balls, that is x upon 12. Now, 6 more black balls are put in the box. Total number of balls becomes 12 plus 6, that is 18. Total number of black balls becomes, it was x before and you are adding 6 more black balls. So, it becomes x plus 6. Therefore, probability of getting a black ball now equal to total number of black balls upon total number of balls, that is x plus 6 upon 18. Now, according to the given information, you will have 2 multiply by x upon 12 equal to x plus 6 upon 18. Now, doing the cancellation of common factors, you will have 3x equal to x plus 6. That is, taking x to the LHS, you will have 2x equal to 6. Therefore, x equal to 3. Therefore, the number of black balls equal to 3. Question number 5. A jar contains 24 marbles. Some are green and others are blue. If a marble is drawn at random from the jar, the probability of that it is a green is 2 upon 3. Find the number of blue balls in the jar. Total number of marbles in the jar, that is given 24. Let the number of green marbles be x. Therefore, number of blue marbles equal to 24 minus x. And it is given probability of a green marble is 2 upon 3. That is, favorable outcome upon total number of outcome. Probability of getting a green marble, that is x upon total number of outcome is 24. So, you will have 2 upon 3 equal to x upon 24. Doing the cross multiplication, you will have 3x equal to 48, that is x equal to 16. Therefore, the number of green marbles in the jar is 16. Therefore, the number of blue marbles equal to 24 minus 16, that is equal to 8. Moving to homework in exercise 15.1, question number 19, 21, 22, 24 and example 13, you have to write it in your notebook as homework. And the sums that we have discussed in the class, that also you have to write it in your notebook. So, lesson number 15 is over. You have to complete the notebook and study properly. Thank you.